Assalamu alaikum. Good evening, people of Pakistan. We have some wonderful news from the UK. Boris Johnson has been confirmed as the Prime Minister of the UK. To celebrate this wonderful news, I am joined by Umar Khan, our political correspondent. Apparently, there are some controversies about this great man, Mr. Johnson.
Very many accusations libeled against the very great Boris Johnson. Truth is, Mr. Boris Johnson has a tiny list of issues that he's been found guilty of.
We want to be clear, this is not you. This is from the liberal snowflake media in the UK.
Yes, indeed. And a massive fuck you to them. Now, number one, they say that Boris lies. They say that he cheats. He takes credit for other people's work. He makes, apparently, this is what they say, racist, sexist, homophobic.
Mashallah.
Remarks. And finally, they say, he looks like a ferret has died on his sir.
But it speaks to the character of the man that despite this sniper-like attack, he has rose to the very, very top. I want to discuss this other thing. He has maybe misspoken about Islam. Please clear this up for everyone at home so we can retract any fatwas coming from the other region.
He said that the sisters who wear the look like letter boxes.
Jeez.
You take the letter and you put in the slot.
Okay, please clear this up because at the moment my support for this great man is decreasing.
Here's a fact. Boris Johnson's great-grandfather was part of the Ottoman Empire. This is Muslim. Sprinkle.
Subhanallah, the last resistance against the martyr infidel.
Takbir!
Allahu Akbar.
One more time, takbir!
Allahu Akbar.
Lovely.
You hear this? He is only 87% Islamophobic, i.e. against the Muslims. That is way below the British average. Thank you very much, Umar Bhai. Now, after the break, we'll be exploring why gay people are causing floods in Sindh and droughts in Lahore.
Gay sex.